It's Dexy. So today we are doing a book review, and I wanted to do it a little bit differently, so it's not just me talking and talking and talking. Yeah, the book we are talking about today is These Violent Delights by Chloe Gong, and I actually got an ARC of it from Netgalley like back in September, I think. So yes, I'm finally reviewing it. It only took me forever. But yeah, the book is actually coming out like I think next week. I believe it was November 17th, the release date. Since it takes place in the 1920s, I thought it would be fun to do a little 1920s makeup look while voiceover Dexy does the actual reviewing. So yeah, I've got a tutorial ready to go here. I'll link this in the description if anyone else is interested in watching it for any reason, because I at least found it pretty helpful. At least the first time I watched it, I don't know how it'll go in practice. I'll just read you the synopsis of the book and then we'll start the makeup process. The year is 1926 and Shanghai hums to the tune of debauchery. A blood feud between two gangs runs the streets red, leaving the city helpless in the grip of chaos. At the heart of it all is 18-year-old Juliet Kai, a former flapper who has returned to assume her role as the proud heir of the Scarlet Gang, a network of criminals far above the law. Their only rivals in power are the White Flowers, who have fought the Scarlets for generations. And behind every move is their heir, Roman Montagu, Juliet's first love and first betrayal. But when gangsters on both sides show signs of instability, culminating in clawing their own throats out, the people start to whisper of a contagion, a madness, of a monster in the shadows. As the deaths stack up, Juliet and Roma must set their guns and grudges aside and work together, for if they can't stop this mayhem, then there will be no city left for either to rule. So yeah, this book is intense. And it's also, if you didn't guess from the character names, it's a Romeo and Juliet retelling. Yeah, I'll let voiceover Dexy take over and I'll get on with the makeup.
Where do I even begin? If it isn't already clear, I love this book. It was a 5-star read. But yeah, here's my page and a half of thoughts on the book. I wasn't sure at first if These Violent Delights would be my thing, because 1920s didn't sound like the most interesting setting to me. But the beautiful cover kept calling to me and everyone on Twitter kept praising it, so I ended up requesting it on Netgalley, and obviously I got it. And yeah, I was hooked from the first chapter pretty much. It immediately started out really interesting. Turns out 1920s Shanghai isn't boring at all, and like learning about what a diverse place it was really fascinating. Because like my knowledge of the history of Shanghai or any places in Asia really isn't that great, because well, I live in a Western country, we kinda skip teaching about anything that isn't Europe or America, which is kinda lame. But yeah, it was really fun to learn a little bit of like something new while reading a fictional book. And I really enjoyed the descriptions of the city, especially from Juliet's perspective. And like, just in general, the writing in the book was really beautiful. I really look forward to Chloe's future books. I also really enjoyed the story and the characters a lot. It's told from the perspective of both Juliet and Roma, and like sometimes also their friends, but mainly Juliet and Roma. So you get the full view of what's going on as they try to solve the mystery of the madness that is spreading in the city. I definitely enjoyed Juliet's perspective the most, because like she's a badass and she has this reputation of being the ruthless Scarlet Gang heir, and she definitely lives up to that reputation. But she's also not completely heartless, so I think she's like a really well-balanced character. She's not one of those characters who are just said to be really brutal, but actually they just don't do anything to show that. But she's also not a cold-hearted killer. She's got feelings too. And Juliet also has this extra layer of complexity from, like, the fact that she has lived in Western countries for years and obviously has picked up a lot of the fashion and culture from there, but she's also proud of being from Shanghai and being the heir of the Scarlet Gang, and she cares about her family, but she definitely dresses like a Western person. It's just, she's an interesting character, I like her. I liked Roma a lot too, but I think I just tend to like female characters more. So Juliet wins just by a little bit. And Roma is definitely softer of the two main characters, and I really enjoyed his and Juliet's interactions together. Like, one of my favorite scenes with them was probably when they were forced to take tequila shots and Roma couldn't handle his booze at all, and Juliet was like, "Aren't you supposed to be Russian?" And Roma was like, "I'm Russian, not an alcoholic." It was really funny. I don't know why that particular scene has stuck into my brain, but it was funny. I feel like I can't talk about Roma as a character as much because a lot of the stuff goes way more into spoiler territory, and obviously I don't want to ruin the book for anyone. He's definitely a complicated character too, his life is not easy. I also really like the romance between Juliet and Roma. Like, I think it developed, or I guess redeveloped, because they had been in love before until stuff happened. But yeah, I think it developed at a really natural pace, considering they used to be enemies. It's a slow burn, but I think it's a good thing, because you don't just suddenly snap and go from "I hate you" to wait a second, "I actually love you." So that was good. The side characters were also great. Both Juliet and Roma have their own two sidekicks, and like I mentioned, we get to see the story from their perspective a little bit as well. Marshall and Benedict are Roma's friends, and they were really fun. I think they had a little bit of comic relief moments every now and then. And then Juliet has these sisters, Rosalind and Kathleen, and I think they seem like really good friends, and I like them a lot. The actual plot of the book isn't really as complicated as it might sound at first, because there's like all these communists and then the Scarlet Gang and White Flower drama, and then just generally dealing with foreigners and stuff, but it's really just pretty straightforward in the end. Something is killing people, and then Juliet and Roma need to figure out what it is. That's the basic plot. But I think there was just the right level of mystery, so at least I couldn't guess the outcome too early. Sometimes it maybe felt a little like Juliet and Roma could get away with things like breaking into places or snooping in places a little too smoothly. But maybe they were just really lucky. I don't know. I feel like wherever they went, they just could get the info and leave, and that's it. Or people just freely offered the information to them. The story gets really intense towards the end though. I remember it being like a total adrenaline spike as things start happening. And yeah, things just get really intense. And the Romeo and Juliet elements were sprinkled in the story nicely as well. Like, I could spot little things throughout the book, even though it's been like, I think it has actually been like over 10 years since I read the original play, and I could still recognize some things. Also, the madness is terrifying, okay? If gory stuff makes you squeamish, this might not be the book for you. Learning what causes people to tear their own throats out, like, actually made me toss my phone away for a moment just to process what the heck I had just read. Yeah, it freaked me out. There are creepy crawlies involved, and it was really nasty. But like, all in all, I really like these violent delights, and I would definitely recommend it if you want like a historical fiction with a dash of fantasy, because you're in for a wild ride of romance and crime and people tearing their own throats out a lot. I really like this book, and it's beautiful, and I definitely look forward to the sequel whenever that comes out. And yeah, this book is coming out in just a few days, so make sure to get it if you are interested. And this is the finished makeup. I was going to put my Claire wig on
for this last clip since it's cute and dark brown and curly, but I couldn't find it. At least my face is very Scarlet Gang right now for the colors. So I hope you like this a little different way of doing a book review, and let me know if I should do more of these in the future. If you want to see more of my nonsense, of course don't forget to subscribe and maybe check out my Patreon and other social media stuff. Oh yeah. Thanks for watching and bye! I dropped the eyeshadow palette I was using as a mirror while I was filming this. So that was a scary moment. But luckily, none of the shadows broke. I just need to put them back.